Good day, everyone. Right, today we're going to take a look through the Lost Tomb of Martek, which is the third in the series of the Desert of Desolation. The first one being Pharaoh, the second one being the Oasis of the White Palm, and this is the final one. Right, what do you get for your buck in this one? Well, you get a 32-page model, and it's written by Tracy Ray Hickman, but I'm going to reserve my opinion on that particular one there. And inside the 32 pages, you're going to have the characters who have collected orbs in the previous two adventures. In the first one, a fleet has been released, and that's in Pharaoh. In the second one, a genie has been released, and both of them are fighting along the Desert of Desolation, destroying anything and everything in their path. And the characters now have got to find the Lost Tomb of Martek for a means of stopping the two creatures from fighting each other. So, given several clues, they make their way across the desert to a place called the Pillars of Martek, where they use the gems. You can see there's a fellow on the Pillar of Martek. You can see that there. Use the gems to open the way into the Tomb of Martek itself. And while they go on the way there, they cross a thing called the Sky Sea, which is probably one of the best things that this model has produced in any of the Desert of Desolation, really. Because this heat was introduced into the desert many, many hundreds, even thousands of years ago. And it fused the sea into a sea of glass, literally. The only way to get across it is through the skating sky ships. And it's the only safe way to get across it, because in the day, the sun beats down with the temperatures and also reflects the sun like a mirror, also with the temperatures. So it can get pretty hot on that glass, and the characters wouldn't survive for very long if they try to walk across it during the day. And being the fact that it's such a wide glass sea, they would take more than a day to cross, so yeah, the characters are pretty much dead if they tried that particular way of them. So this is the only way to get across it. So once they figured out the puzzle, they get into a garden, the Garden of the Cursed, where there's a lot of different creatures to encounter, which are mostly men, villains, religious people, and so on, have somehow stumbled into the garden itself. And using the gems then to take themselves into the different parts of the tomb. And basically it's just an excuse to throw some bits and pieces in for the characters just to extend, if you like, the actual model's length. The best one of this sort of encounters they have is the Mobius Tower. Now the Mobius Tower is an endless loop of a place where they just go up the stairs, it'll carry on going up the stairs forever in the day. They go in through a room and carry on going through rooms forever in the day in a massive circular way of it. And all the people inside this Mobius Tower have been frozen in statues, and they just don't move at all. They're like living statues. The time really literally just stops still for them. And so the characters have to figure a way out of that particular trap, which they do eventually, because there are plenty of clues left around lying about for them. And eventually they get to the crypt, and they wake up good old Martek after various little bits and pieces to get there. Right, now, when I said this was written by Hickman, I suspect it might not have been. I think Hickman gave a few ideas to this module and might have written one or two bits and pieces, but I think other people have gotten themselves involved in writing this. Because if you compare the standard of this model to the previous two, you can find it very, very lacking in a lot of ways. I mean, sure, they follow the format of the previous two models, where they have trip, tracks, play, and so on and so forth, which is pretty good in that and of itself, in all three models. The problem lies in the execution. I mean, there's no explanation for some of the stuff that goes on in there. And certainly with the encounters they have are pretty forgettable, apart from the Mobius Tower. The other encounters they have in the adventure could be lifted out of any other adventure, or even put into any other adventure. There is nothing in there that would really I think what will happen is the Canada's who play this will be disappointed, because the end is a huge anticlimax. You wake up Martek, the big guy. He goes off and battles the Ifriti and the genie. The playing characters do nothing. They sit down, have a cup of tea, have a few pints, talk, bullshit with each other, and not lift a finger to have the battle going on. And as a result, it's much of an anticlimax. And I said the quality of the adventure is very much down on the previous two, and the maps with the different areas which the can't explore. And that's bloody rubbish, the crystal map place, I'm sorry to say. So overall, it's a disappointing end to the Desert of Desolation series, and certainly haven't played this exactly as is. I've done a fair amount of changes to make it a little bit more exciting. Problem is, with those fair amount of changes, I've totally taken away the ethos of the model itself, and it's not not Lotto Martek, it's some different events entirely. That's how much work I put into it, and I had to change it. What else was that? Oh yeah, the fact is as well, this is set in the Desert of Desolation. You have absolutely no implication or idea of the desert itself. It's just in the side. It's a place which you just plonked into. So don't get that Sahara desert type feel about the whole module. In fact, you don't get very much desert travel at all. You've got the Sky Sea, and maybe a day or two going across the sands, but nothing in there to evoke the desert and the culture and the people you find therein. It just, personally speaking, I think it's a throwaway model, and as a result, and the fact that I had to change it so much to get it to be playable, I've literally thrown it away. Well, not literally, I mean in terms of usage and all that, I've just not bothered with it. I played the first two models and sort of tied it up in the Oasis of the White Palm, and I will cover that in another video sometime. So anyway, thanks for watching, and sorry to not be too positive about this, but I find it hard to be positive about this. Other people may think, yeah, I'm wrong, and this is one of the best models ever written. That's not really entitled to think that, and that's an opinion, and you're fine, you can walk yourself up with it. But for me personally, I don't like it, and I probably never will, and there's a huge amount of work to be done to it to make it at least playable and follow in with the quality of the first two models in the series. This was actually done as well, put together in the super model, the Desert of Desolation model, which I will cover again sometime in the future. I will probably be as disparaging of this section of the model in that super model as I am now. Okay, so take care. Thanks for watching. Rock on.